The key word is sustainability. That's why the Vanderhoffs won this award. It wasn't just that they installed a digester. It's a long-term commitment to many aspects of sustainability across their entire dairy enterprise. You have a system like this, 80, 90% of everything that you really want is extracted out of it first and then applied to the field. Add in benefits like capturing the greenhouse gases, killing off pathogens, you end up with a system that is truly environmentally beneficial and environmentally sustainable.
Well, the process starts basically with the cows. The manure comes from the cows.
Initially, this digester was running on cow manure only, and then the dairy had sourced pre-consumer food waste to blend in with the manure.
We're getting material from all of Western Washington. Chicken grease, wastewater from food processing.
It's made a good feed source for the digester. Potentially, it's doubled their energy output.
Once the manure and the food waste get mixed together, it's pumped into the digester to run through the process. As the manure breaks down, it releases methane gas.
What an anaerobic digester does is just takes this natural bacterial process and puts it into an enclosed facility, captures that methane.
Which is turned into electricity through an engine, about 400 to 600 kW at a time. That's enough to power 300 to 400 houses.
What we're trying to do is do a whole system of technologies that work in concert with the digester. So what's happening at Vanderhoff Farm right now is that after the digester, we remove the fiber material that can be sold as peat moss, send the remaining liquid to have ammonia extracted, and the ammonia is stored as a fertilizer in the white tanks behind me, and that ammonia fertilizer can be applied to the field at the farmer's convenience.
It turns it into a top quality fertilizer for the crops to grow.
There still is a remaining liquid, and that is being sent to this settling lane that's below this black cover that we see, and solids that contain phosphorus drop out.
That's some of the research we're doing with Washington State University in order to get the nitrogen and the phosphorus to levels where we can easily transport them to fields that need the fertilizer. At the end of the digester process, 99% of the bacteria is eliminated. The solids are used as bedding for the cows, creating a clean, comfortable material for the cows to lay on. Happy cows make more milk.
In a normal dairy, they would scrape the manure and it would go into a lagoon and then from the lagoon to the field.
This way we can recycle the material, produce power out of it, and use the excess for fertilizers.
So just imagine, you know, really what we've accomplished in terms of sustainability by the end of all of this.
This is a better way to recycle those nutrients and capture the energy. Yeah, I was surprised to win the award, but the award isn't for me, it's for everybody in the whole process.